Thank you for downloading and installing Power BI Desktop. Welcome. The very first step to building data visualizations is to get data. We can do this from a variety of places in Desktop. You can use the Get Data button right from this welcome screen. Use the Ribbons Data section to choose amongst popular or recent sources, or use the Canvas watermarks. But what if you don't have your own data? You can use our sample data set to get started. You can find our sample reports and datasets in our documentation and save it to your machine, or you can use this handy button here for Try a Sample Dataset. When you click on Try a Sample Dataset, you'll be given a choice to follow along with our tutorial, or you can experiment on your own by choosing Load. Here you'll see the Navigator. When I click on an item, the Navigator provides a preview of the data so you can verify that you have the correct range of data. You'll also notice the numeric data types are italicized. You have the option to transform or load the data. If you need to make any changes before loading, transform your data now. To make visualizations easier to read later, I'd like to make a few modifications. One of the top data cleaning steps users do most often is changing data types. In this case, the units sold are in decimal form. It doesn't make sense to have a fraction of a unit sold, so let's change that to a whole number. I'd also like to rename a column. Let's shorten the column name from month name to just month. I can double-click on the month name column or use the right-click menu and rename to just month. And the last change I'd like to make is to filter. We know the Montana product was discontinued last month, so we want to filter this data from our report to avoid confusion. All right, this looks great. Our data is ready for building a report. I'm going to save these changes by choosing Close and Apply. You'll notice as the data loads, the field pane expands to display your data ready to build visuals. To start on my report, I first want to add a title, so let's insert a text box and add our title. Now, I want to create a line chart to see which month and year had the highest profit. From the Fields pane, I drag the Profit field to a blank area on the report canvas and date to the same visual. Power BI automatically creates a date hierarchy for me, and this is handy if I'd like to use a drill through, but I'd prefer to use just date for this visual. Lastly, I swap the viz type to a line chart and position it to where I'd like it in my report. Next, I want to create a map to see which country had the highest profits. I drag country and profit onto the canvas. If I wanted to change this to a fancier map, I can also find custom visuals through this dot 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 menu, get more visuals, and browse the AppSource marketplace to add more visuals to Power BI Desktop. For our next visual, I'd like to create a bar chart to determine which companies and segments to invest in. As another method to insert a visualization, I first choose Cluster Column Chart, then I drag Sales to the Values field well, Product as what I'd like to show on the axis, and Segment to the Legend. I'm going to reposition and resize this so it fits below my other two visuals. My last visual I'd like to add is a slicer. Slicers are valuable tools for filtering the visuals on a report page to a specific selection. I select Slicer and choose the Date field. This time I want to use the date hierarchy, so I can select Year and Month only. If I wanted to format each visual one by one, I'd select a visual and use the Format pane to make edits, like colors, adding data labels, or a border. But if I wanted to format all my visuals at once, I can change the theme from the View tab in the ribbon and use the Themes dropdown. Wow, this looks great! Let's save this report. I also want to be able to share and collaborate with colleagues on this, so I'll need to publish my report up to the Power BI service. Here I choose the workspace destination, like my workspace, and publish. When I open my report in the Power BI service, I can see what my report readers will see. I can also interact with my report. If I wanted to see just a particular country's data, I can cross-highlight by choosing a country from the map. Or I can use my slicer to filter to just 2014's data, and you'll see all the other visuals update according to my selection. Okay, it's time to share my insights with others. At the top, I select the Share button, and here I can type in email addresses for one colleague or a whole group to view and access my report. Woohoo! You just learned all the basics to get started with Power BI Desktop. Get data, transform data, build and format visuals, save, publish, and share. As you embark on your Power BI journey, our community is a great resource to ask questions and interact with others. You can also suggest and vote on new feature ideas on our ideas site. Thanks for watching!